Hello everyone, welcome to my Meli Melo channel. Today we are going to be talking about the 10 things I love about Germany, right? Have you seen it? I've removed my flag. The very first thing I love about Germany is the language. People say it's difficult, but I just love it. It has a spirit that I love. I mean, we used to play, say, look, when you say I love you in English, I love you. Like, there's a little bit of emotion in it. When you say it in French, it's je t'aime, right? Ti amo. But in German, it's ich liebe dich. Just that you know that I love you. But those are but I just love the language. They are words that means a lot. The spirit, like when they say Geist, it's actually a ghost, but it's something very, it can be a ghost, it can be intelligent, it can be alcohol. Like 20%, 40% of Geist, and there are a lot of words. I mean, you should just, I love the language. I've ever loved it. I feel that this maybe the only part that I see a kind of passion. It's a language that requires passion, right? The language. Second is the geographics. It's just like you have sea, you have plain land, and you have mountains, hills, and all over the territory there are lakes, Bodensee, Chiemsee, and Sächsische Schweiz. Like there's a lot of things to do here, and the national parks and hiking culture has to do also with the geographics, and almost everywhere you have like a big how is it called, river. You have a big river, and the living quality is not that, it's really good actually for someone who loves nature, right? And that was point two. Point three is let me look it over. It's the tidiness. Like, there is something about being tidy and everything at its right place and rules and whatnot. It makes the cities, I mean, there are some spots that are not, but if I compare with other countries where I've been to, other Western countries that I've been to, cleanness, the overall cleanness of the territory is nice. I love it. I love that there's this keep Germany tidy culture, or maybe somewhere they call it the Schwäbische Kehrwoche. It's like it's your turn if you're living together in a story building, each one, not even that big story, but normal home for rent, when you are renting, you have like, today's your turn to keep the stairways, the staircase clean, or the front. So overall, it makes the whole place, when everyone is cleaning, then everywhere is clean. And I love that about them. It's not perfect, some people still grumble, but I mean, it's a really higher level to be grumbling about tidiness in Germany. They're tidy. I love it. And the next thing that I really love about Germany are the ancient houses. They call it Fachwerk. I mean, those houses have been standing for 100-300 years, and they are still standing. The new homes, when the next rain or whatnot comes, or wind, everything is down. But the Fachwerk houses, they are standing. They have been standing for 300 years, and maybe they will still stand for the next 300 years. And there's just something about them. When you go to these middle cities, most of the time, even Frankfurt in the middle of the city, when you really go to like Pfaffenhoek, there is a lot of fuck there charm that, and it's everywhere, and I just love it. Berlin is different, but there are a lot of middle to little cities with great centers made out of this factory. I know you people want sky, some people only want skyliner and whatnot, but that's my thing. And I've not yet found any person in my contacts that really loves it. They just look as if old, but there is identity in architecture, and I find it okay. By the way, I think if I'm not mistaken, there are a lot of city centers that have been copied by somewhere, like really copying the whole center of a city somewhere else. So there's something about it, so it's not on my thing. Next point is the federalismus, or maybe I'm just saying that in English and in German. I mean, Germany is a little EU. Sorry, I'm tired. I'm not tired, but I'm hungry, right? And they have like 16 Bundesländer or states, but it's Bundesländer, call it that way. And everyone has his own. Each state has his own competencies, and there's nothing someone from Berlin is going to come and talk. And that makes, for me, that is the essence of democracy in Germany. I know people are complaining, but I just love it because it's like it's a pillar to democracy here. There are some things to do, but that is what I love, and you are going to love it or maybe hate it, but if I think it's a nice thing to have 16 almost dependent and independent states coming together. It's historical. And which brings me about liberalism, brings me to speed limit. There is no speed limit in Germany. There are some restrictions here and there, but when possible, go for it. It's like it's free. We are living Schumachers, Michael Schumachers everywhere. And you know I love speed. If you've seen my 20 Facts About Me video, and you know, I love this. I really love this. Those are things I really enjoy having in Germany. No speed limit. And then the other side, what I really love is the weapon policies. If you want to get something, you will get it, but it is not like people are, they are not, a normal person, it's not easy for a normal person with a normal mind, not willing just to think that, to get to a weapon. Like, if you have to compare to America, there are ways the bad people get to their weapon, but it's not like you have the right to wear a weapon. It's just the army, the police and whatnot, they have this exclusivity of wearing weapon, but a normal citizen, nope. And that makes me feel it's a runabout security about. I really know that. I'm just comparing to the US, the United States of America. I love that part. Next point that I really love, I don't really know how I'm going to put it, but I just love the German word, Bodenständigkeit. Boden is the floor and ständig to stand on the floor. So that's the Bodenständigkeit. They are like, most of them, simple-minded people. Grounded. They are grounded people, like, it's a thing. There's no bossing. People really live, they love a simple life, but know that there's something different, but they're happy with little things, most of them. Like, it shouldn't be extra. Even when they are getting married, it's okay. It's Well, it's bodenständig. Make it, keep it down to earth. They keep everything down to earth. Next point that I love about Germany, they are solution finders, right? There's a word TÜV. Like the whole industry is based on people looking for solutions, looking for trying things. This is try and fail and try and truth. The whole economical industry is based on people looking for solution. And once in a while, find something great, like Bosch or something, with a motor, the way to lighting. Anyway, it's not my finding solution. They are great at that. And last but not least, and you are going to enjoy it. I mean, winter is a dark season, right? It's a season where you might think, but when you get Germany in the Christmas season, it's unbelievable. It starts with the 1st of December. You have this Christmas market starting from there. Some even start way before. And there's a lot of life. People go out and socialize. You start like Nikolaus, right? On the 6th of December. You have to put your shoes, I mean the kiddies, right? Put your shoes out, and if you were a good boy or a good girl, a good child, a good parent, a good mother, whatnot, you there's no father, you get some treats, chocolate, and they call it Nikolaus, but not for the Christmas, like. And the whole season, the whole Christmas season is just, I enjoy it. So those were my 10 things I love about Germany. And you should keep watching, because if I have 10 things I love, I might be doing 10 things I don't love about Germany. And there are quite a lot, right? So, subscribe to my channel. See ya later. Bye. Mwah.